Hi everyone, how's it going? Tim here, and this is part 6 of the course on building Electron desktop apps. So last time we talked about Crunchyroll, and this time I want to talk about adding the YouTube plugin and handling multiple sources actually. So the thing is, I didn't stream adding the YouTube plugin at all because I talked a bit to the guys on the Discord channel and then, you know, give it a few minutes of thought, and basically there's no reason to stream that because it essentially works in more or less the same way that the Crunchyroll does, because we decided not to go for the YouTube API, which are kind of a pain in the ass to use, to be honest, and just go with scraping. And, you know, since we're scraping, the only thing that differs from the Crunchyroll is actually those selectors that we use here, because the data format is exactly the same. The way they loaded and parsed is the same. There's a slightly difference in episode fetching, because in the Crunchyroll we had to decode all this thing. In this case, we just need to run one simple regular expression and we basically get everything that we need. I skipped fetching the subtitles for now. We'll see if we want to do that or not, because, you know, that's parsing, that's not Electron development, so I wouldn't care about that too much. The authentication is done in the same way through the window. Getting serious, also same. Search is kind of same-ish. Settings, again, logout, login button, nothing fancy here, so that's why I skipped it. You know, if you're interested, have a look at how I did it, but, you know, there's nothing special about it. It's more or less the same as Crunchyroll, as I already said. Now, the interesting bit is how both of them integrate and how both of them are called together, right? So the idea is, before, in every page, we called specifically Crunchyroll plugin, right? So we have here Crunchyroll get episode. So now the thing is, we have multiple plugins. And let me just start this thing. And now, actually, when we open the app, we see not only the Crunchyroll, but also the YouTube here. So the YouTube comes first, because I guess it was loaded first in my case. And then we get the Crunchyroll stuff. Obviously, Crunchyroll has, you know, nicer thumbnails and a lot more like video counts and everything. But YouTube also works here. It's like we have honest trailers from Screen Junkies. We got some Grong. I don't know half of those channels, but whatever. This is what is trending on YouTube now. And I'm only fetching the channels, so I'm skipping the videos. Only unique channels here. So, you know, you kind of can see what's going on, what's trending, what channels are trending basically on YouTube. My series works in exactly the same way. So, okay, this is only for YouTube. I think I'm not logged in actually into Crunchyroll right now, but whatever. So this works fine. And again, you know, if you pick something and click on it, so like Screen Junkies, for example, we can actually get the list of their latest videos. Again, not paginated, nothing, just gets the latest ones. And if you click on a specific video, it will load as well in a player. This is directly streamed from YouTube, so works as you expect. Basically nothing fancy. So how does it work? Well, as I said, we are no longer calling get episode for one specific plugin. We now have a plugin manager that handles everything. The way it is created, it's basically a class that takes in a list of plugins in a constructor. So we have an array of plugins here and we throw in the Crunchyroll and YouTube. And the way it works after that, it has exactly the same methods as all the plugins do. But depending on what method is called, it will do different things. So like most of those are actually very, very stupid and simple, because once again, the methods are all the same and the results are uniform. So all the data return is always the same from all the plugins. So only the type, I think, differs. Again, if we're doing all series, what I'm doing here is I call all plugins and I map them to the plugin called series method with page and await all of that and just reduce the results. So this basically will contain an array of arrays, because all of them returns arrays. And then I reduce it into one array, so flatten it essentially. And that's actually not even needed, because we directly listen to the database. But, you know, just for the sake of it, I did it. Same for the episodes. So in this case, since the episode getting episodes is bound to the series, I actually first find the find the plugin whose ID is equals to the source of the series. So, you know, Crunchyroll, YouTube, whatever. So this is the type field, basically the source type field. And then I call that plugin with get episodes for the series, and then everything else happens on its own, basically. Same is for episode, again, search by plugin ID, then just call the function. Get my series works in same way as get all series, only, you know, get my series is called, again, array of results, search, same, gonna be searched all over all the plugins. And then draw settings is simply an array of all plugins called when draw settings, which will basically render a bunch of cells, and this is exactly what we want. So it's kind of straightforward. The cool part is that we can easily throw in more plugins, if you know, as long as they have the same methods. So we need what, get all series, get episodes, get episode, get my stuff and search and draw settings, obviously, if at least it has to return an empty string or null. As long as we have those methods, we can actually throw in as many sources as we want. So right now we have only two, which is enough to show how that works and enough to kind of build the core of it, you know. But theoretically, we can throw in whatever else search sources you can imagine out there that have this sort of close-ish data structure, let's put it this way. It's worth mentioning that this is like one of the points where typings and, you know, stuff like TypeScript and Flow can help you a lot, because since those methods are uniform, since they always return the same things, they always take the same inputs, having type definitions for them helps a ton. So if you are like doing a complex project that requires this kind of integrations, then looking at TypeScript or Flow or, you know, any other statically typed language is kind of can be very helpful. But in this case, I decided to just take it easy and, you know, do it like this. So maybe we'll look at the TypeScript in some later courses. So yeah, this is about it for this part. I think besides this plugin stuff, there was like one thing where I added this player destruction, as someone already actually mentioned that either in the chat or in comments, that unless you dispose of the player when you leave the page, you won't be able to create a new one. So I did that, because otherwise you can actually switch between episodes, which is a bit of a pain. And I think other than that, there wasn't actually any other changes here. So it seems to be working just fine. As you know, as I showed you here, we actually have, you know, access to all the series. And in terms of anime, we get like actually the episodes. In terms of YouTube, we get the videos from the specific channel. There's some German cooking TV. I have no idea what is that. It works. So the next step would be to actually start. So we talked that we want to do a multi-source desktop app that will play videos and we'll have a chat in it. So the idea is next to take the URL or ID of the episode. So like we take something like this, we open the episode, and the idea is to make it an interactive experience. So let me just pause that real quick. We also need to maybe adjust the styling a bit, because this is like doesn't really fit the screen. The idea is to have a chat box, you know, in a way that, for example, Twitch has, I guess. So we will have a video player on the left and then chat box on the right, which chat will be tied to this specific episode. And whoever is watching it at this moment will be able to actually discuss what is happening in there, which, you know, I mean, it's, I imagine there's going to be a ton of problems from like conceptual standpoint, because people talking about the episode and spoilers and all that kind of stuff. But that doesn't matter right now. I just want to do to show you how to use WebSockets and how to build a real-time chat, basically. So this is what we're going to focus on. And yeah. I think this is going to be in the next live streams. That shouldn't take too much. So we're going to write a server that will do that. And we're going to write a client that will work on like client part of it. But it's going to be super stupid. It's not going to store any history or anything. So it's going to be just real time, whatever, you know, if people are watching the same episode at the same time, they can talk. If not, then, well, all history is wasted. So it's going to be like directly peer-to-peer. I mean, I guess not peer-to-peer in this case, because it's going to go through the server. But it's basically the history won't be stored anywhere. The server will just act as a mediator who sends messages around. I guess that's it for this part. So as always, thank you for watching, and I see you in the next live stream or in the next episode. Bye.